kick off me. So first of all, welcome, welcome to our third annual, Dancing for the Future. Dancing for the Future. Many of us have been through this once or twice, and so that's very exciting. So it's not like our first year. So a lot of us have kind of competed off the last couple of years. Thank you guys for coming. For those of you who have not been with us before, I'm going to probably just give you a little bit of a download of what this whole event's about. I'm going to hand out a flyer to you that we can kind of go over and kind of the a little bit of the details. I'll introduce our team. Oh, somebody's there. You go. I'll introduce our committee and all that kind of good stuff. But just to get you guys started real quick, this event started 3 years ago. And the idea behind this event is the dollars that we raise goes back into, it's a 501c3, and it's through Midshore Community Foundation. So it's a nonprofit organization, a nonprofit group, Dancing for the Future. And every penny that we raise goes back into, for our students. It is not given to the Board of Education. It goes back into the schools for our students. And that was kind of the premise behind it. And our goal is to hit, there's 15 schools counting our Anchor Academy in the system, and the goal is with these dollars to be able to touch each of those schools. And we have been. We've raised over the last 2 years $8,500. $85,000. So our goal this year is to raise $85,000 just at this event, just so you know. Just so you guys know. We're going to set our goals really high.
No pressure.
It's all good. Cute about it. So that's what we've been able to do. If you have not visited our website, the website's on here. It's www.dancingforthefuture.com. If there's letters promoting to the schools that we've been able to assist, things that we've been able to do. There's pictures from the last few years of the events. As we go on, I have programs from last year just to hand out to everybody. I have this to hand out. And have some other fun things to do. But I know the main goal of our evening is to introduce you, the stars, to the pros. And that's the funnest part of it. But because that's the funnest part of it, we're going to do it at the end. So we don't lose interest. Because once we introduce everybody, then it becomes, it's a free-for-all. And everybody kind of goes off. But anyway, the idea behind this is not only to give funds back into the school, but if you're, Queen Anne's County itself is a pretty big county. And our goal was to not only raise dollars for our kids, but also to bring our community together. You know, North County, there's South County, and a lot of times they're very disconnected. And so what we do is we grab dancers and stars and professionals from all over the county, and we put everybody in the same room for the same common goal. So that's kind of cool, because at the night of the event, everybody's there like, what? You know, they're all raising money for our kids, and then we're all together. So it's a very, So it's basically about bringing our community together. It's very exciting. I will hand this out to you guys. If I could have our committee, everybody that's on the planning committee, if you guys could all raise your hands, please. Yay, okay, yay, let's hear for these guys. Yay! These guys have been, and I'll name them as we go, you're gonna meet them in detail here sooner than later. But this is a planning committee that has been together, that has been working feverishly, but getting the pros and the stars together, getting the event set up. The event as last year is going to be at Chesapeake Bay Beach Club. If you're not familiar with it, it's when you come over the bridges on the right-hand side. The first year, it's going to be back in the room that we had the first year. So it's going to be back in that room again. We thought last year's room was pretty good, but whatever. It's a free room. So now we're back at that first room that we are, and I can't remember what the name of that room was. Sunset room. So we're in the sunset room. The event is on the 19th of November. The doors open to the public at 7, or the doors open, I think, at 6:30. We want you guys to arrive like at 5:30. So you can kind of get used to the floor. But we'll get into all of those details. You know what, let me go around. I've got Dr. Daryl Calloway and Lucia Calloway. These guys have been our main dance pros from day one. They actually have been the motivation of this entire event. I saw Lucia walking down the hallway, so there's a middle school one day after a basketball practice, and go, what are you doing? And she's like, I'm practicing for dancing for the dogs. And I was like, what? We should do that in our county. So here we are. So these guys have been, these guys are our professionals, and we lean on them a lot. So just so you guys know. So anyway, we're going to go through, I'm just going to go through this if this is good for you guys. Our judges this year, we added a judge. This year we added a judge. We still have Dr. Carol Williamson. What? Our chief academic administrator for the state of Maryland.
Yay.
Can you just say that nice and loud?
Thank you.
Our loss.
Very much so. So, and then we have Mr. Lance Richardson. He tends to be our cut up of the evening, giving a little bit of alcohol and who knows what comes out. But it's all good, though. It's all good, right, Denise? It's all good. Sharon Dobson, who was our one of our judges last year, she will also be returning. And we added Kristen Tyler as one of our judges this year. As a request of last year, it was a request of maybe we add a judge with some more dance experience. Not saying that you guys don't know what you're saying. Because we all get a little bit serious. It's all good. But we are very excited. So you will see, you'll see them now, and it's great that they came out, but they will also be here the night of the event. Our Master of Ceremonies has been the Master of Ceremonies for the last 3 years. He's also our county administrator, and very easy for me to get in contact with, Mr. Greg Todd.
What?
I didn't, okay. So anyway, so you guys know, the night, so what happens is, every dancer gets a complimentary ticket, and it's a standing only type of complimentary ticket. We're gonna try, the goal of this event is to raise money for our kids. And so we have tables to buy, we have you to be auctioned online for people, you know, vote for you online. But what we want to make sure is that all of our dancers have the ability to put a business-sized ad in our program, and that's at no charge. So you can put a program in there. And then everybody gets a ticket for a guest. So that's kind of part of it. And we don't want to use up all of these seats, so we kind of say standing room only. And so what's happened in the past is they either stand, and then we end up putting some chairs and stuff around that they can just kind of sit on. It's not a designated table. What happens is people really want to get into the designated table. They want a table of four, they want a table of six, or they want a table of 10. And we really want to make sure we sell those. Our first year, we were like trying to get it all set up, and we ended up, you know, giving away like half of our tables because we gave them to our dancers. And so that's what we were trying to make sure that we were...
Hi, I am Natalie.
This is Natalie Garrett.
Natalie, come join us.
Hey, Diego.
Hello.
So that's just to kind of give you an idea what you get. So everybody gets something in the program. The way it works, anything you sell from here on out it goes as a point towards you. Our goal for you is a fundraiser, and I mainly focus on our stars for this, because our professionals, they help as well, but they're choreographing it, they're setting the music, but it's really we focus on our stars to do this as a major fundraiser. Is anything that you do, if you get a sponsorship, if you get a donation, if you get people to vote for you, that's worth a point. And our goal is to get at least every dancer to raise at least $3,000 each. That's our goal. And if you purchase a table, that would go as well. It would be great if you purchased a table and then raised $3,000. That would be amazing. But that's just so you know, from here on out, anything that's online that's in your name, for your name stars and or for your pros, goes towards you as a couple, because you guys are a couple now. And then, you know, those are the points that you raise. And those are the dollars that you raise. Advertising, this year we're doing a couple of different things. We're kind of excited. We're still doing the website. The website's going to get updated. We're on Twitter. I know when it's getting there. We were going to be on WCEI. Not sure what that's going to be, but it's going to be fun. We're going to have commercials. We'll be on WCEI. We're going to be in the paper, just like we've done before. We're going to be on QACTV. We have Mr. Jeff Strait. Jeff. Woo! Yes. Don't know Jeff, he is good. He is our videographer, and he also works with the school system, but he videos everything that we're doing. He'll also be videoing little snippets of our like we'll do a commercial and then he'll put it on QACTV and then we'll do a commercial, like a commercial type that's closer to the event, and Daryl and I will be talking and then you guys will be like practicing behind us, and then we put that on QACTV. And Dwayne, it's amazing. You're gonna have a lot of fun with this. So the idea is to get as much publicity and get your face out there as much as possible. Those are all different ways that we are now. I have to go to the next page to the event and advertise. I have something else to send out for you. The ads in the program. A quarter page ad is $75, a half page ad is $150, and a full page ad is $300. This is a great way to promote yourself and to get people to sponsor you. If you get people to buy these, it goes in your name. And if you go onto the website, you can do it all, right, Lise? You can do it all on the website through credit card if you like. If there's also a way for you to send a check to Mentor Community Foundation to that address. But if you'd like to do stuff with credit card, just go to the website. I don't know, Lisa, is there any specific way they need to do it if they...
It's just under sponsorship. I think there's like a link. There's a link from the website to the Mid-Shore site.
And you can also get to the link through the vote button, too.
Okay, so that's Lisa Darden. She is the wizard of our financial system, and anything that's on the website when it comes to voting, and you name it, she's our financial wizard. So that's Lisa if you need her. And the other lady talking was Diane, and Diane is the wizard behind any graphics that you see. So she is the one that puts these programs together, puts our posters together, puts our website together. And as we go on, we're going to talk to others that are out here. So just so you guys are identifying. VIP tables. So this is kind of the layout of what the dance floor looks like at Sunset Room.
Sunset Ballroom.
Okay, the yellow are the VIP tables, which means they are circling the dance floor, which are hot tables to have and very fun ones to have. There's 10 seats at each of the VIP tables. We do not put the VIP tables out on the website until the 19th of September. We offer them to the dancers if you guys want them first. And so we want to give you the opportunity to, right, the opportunity to purchase these as soon as possible. And of course our goal is, you know, the sooner we can start filling up tables, the easier it gets for us. So that would be, so if you guys want to, you can go on the website now and you can buy these tables. The 10 seat tables are $1,250. What is a VIP table? And very exciting. And then we also give like little gift drinks, or what do we do, Lise? A little
a ticket for a free glass of wine. I can't remember how we did it last year.
Yeah, we get a little ticket. So we like
that's a little ticket.
So what happens the night of the event, when your guests get there, the first hour the bar is open. So usually it's a free for all, but it's a fun free for all. It's a beer and wine at the bar. But it's an open bar. And then we have hors d'oeuvres. We're not heavy hors d'oeuvres. I know they're like heavy light and light hors d'oeuvres. These are light hors d'oeuvres. We're all working on the budget. It is at the beach club. It's amazing, but it is at the beach club, so we're in the beach club. So they're light hors d'oeuvres, and they are also passed around at the open portion of the open bar. And then there's also like crackers and stuff there that we've had out, so there's some kind of periodically through the rest of the evening. Not a major meal. I'm going to jump on you real quick. We recommend that you eat before the event, or your guests eat before the event, and don't think that this is going to be the meal of the night for them. Noxie's Grill? Noxie's
Table.
Noxie's Table, also part of the Beach Club area, they have set it up so that that night, if you go in there like at 5 or 5:30 and you mention this event, a portion of your meal goes towards the event, which is great. This year they've also opened it up, and we'll send an email out to you guys and kind of circle it. We'll get it on the website and all that kind of stuff. But now it's the first, all the Wednesdays, and they just told me this today, Lisa, all the Wednesdays before the event are at Noxie's Grill. And if you go into Noxie's for dinner and mention this event, they'll give us a percentage of it. And then it's Saturday. So we were looking for a lot more days, so we got 3 more days, so that's good. So if you're looking for food and you want to go to Noxie's Grill, we'll send you the dates out, and those will be times. And then just the percentage. Last year, it's a couple hundred bucks. And we only had a handful of people go for dinner before, but it was still, it was a, you know, easy way for us to make some cash for the kids. But anyway, this is a seating chart. Those are the VIP tables. We also are going to have 6-seat tables and 4-seat tables. The 6-seat tables are $500 each. The 4-seat tables are $350 each. And then an individual admission ticket, if people just want to come and buy them, is $80. So that kind of gives you an idea of what you get for, I mean, what the prices are. If you are interested, so we have gone out prior to this event and started to secure sponsorships. Sponsorships, we kicked the price up this year. We were feeling lucky. So we kicked the price up this year. We have a PhD sponsorship, which if you're a PhD sponsorship, it's a $5,000 sponsorship, and everything that we do from here on out will say sponsored by blah. You know, Disney for the Future is sponsored by your name in the company. That was kind of the goal of the $5,000 sponsorship. The Master's Scholar sponsorship is a $2,000 sponsorship. You'd be on all the advertisements. Go ahead.
It should be $2,500.
Oh, $2,500. That is Jane. Jane was she was one of our star dancers in the, she's also part of our committee, was one of our star dancers in the first year. One of our winners, let me just say. And one of our very good sources of information. And anyway, we're gonna suck their brains in a little bit about other ways to raise money. So it's $2,500. So that's a lie. That's a lie in ethics paper. But and then the bachelor sponsorship is $1,000. I have a handout here. And this kind of breaks out the sponsorship if you're interested in doing the sponsorships. We have posters for you guys today. We have posters of you. This is why we were anxious trying to get the picture of you guys. We have pictures of you with your stars and your professionals. Just to get us moving, because I know before we didn't have posters, and so we thought, at least it gets us started. If, you know, we start getting different sponsors, we'll update the posters, and we can get more posters and things to everybody. I can send it to you as a PDF. You can market yourself however you feel like you want to do that. So we all, you know what, let me talk about my community even a little bit more. I've got Patty right there. Patty, raise your hand. Patty danced last year with us.
She's
one of our stars. So these guys, Jane and Patty, did a phenomenal job also in fundraising. So as we go on, we're gonna team each of these couples up with one of us, so you guys can suck us with questions. And so you can always contact me, and you can always contact Daryl. But we're gonna give you one of our committee members, kind of as your go-to person. Is as time goes on, you're just like, what about, you know? And then our goal is to dedicate to you guys, to help you, whether it would be with practices, locations, dances, if you were trying to figure out other ways to raise money.
First of all, I want to say also on behalf of Lucia and myself, this is amazing that you guys are all here tonight. You all come together for this one cause, and many of you come from miles and set aside a lot to be here and to do this whole project. So thank you very much, all of you. You've bit off something here. We hope you can chew it and swallow it just fine. Lucia and I often say this is our 15th one of these. So we have done quite a few Dancing with the Stars events. They're fun, they're rewarding, but you're going to have to put some work in. And so we're looking forward to that. The final night, it's amazing what you will look at. Look like, all of you. You'll just
like.
Look like.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Hello.
And we'll video
tape. Yeah, that's right. About half of you we've seen dance before, and we're really looking forward to seeing you again. So we have some real great people here. But back to something that Cindy said. Patty Boyer was one of our champions last year, and I asked her permission if I could do this, and she said yes. She's such a good fundraiser. She kind of put together like a sample letter. This is really good. If every star could take one, that would be great. And this letter, sometimes people say, well, I don't know how to raise money if they've done it before. What do I do? And this letter is fabulous. So thank you, Patty, for doing that. And it's just a start. If you want to send that to your friends and relatives, business associates, whatever, then that's one way that you can do it. Everything goes to help our kids, and that's what we're after.
So what will happen, so as you guys know, as the voting starts and it gets closer, we will send out, Lisa's like a tally, and we send out to everybody kind of where you're at with votes. And it becomes very competitive, which is very fun. Because, you know, I mean, it's all about you know, it's all about having fun, but the competition is kind of cool too. So we let send everybody out, and then, you know, the minute we kind of send it out, everybody's like, ooh, you know, they start kind of asking people, did you send this in, did you send that? And so it's very, it's a bit of a competitive sport,
yeah.
My observation.
And if you're a dancer, pro or star, please take one of these purple sheets, because these are what I call the guidelines. They're to help you along the way, because questions haven't popped into your head yet that you're going to have later on, and we want to help you with some of them right now. So at the top of the lilac sheet, it has my phone number, home and cell, and my email address, and Lucia's and Cindy's. So if you have any questions at all about anything, feel free to contact us. We want to help you as much as possible. We want this to be the most spectacular night we've ever had, and I think it will be.
We're going to raise $85,000 this year.
Woo-hoo. Yes,
indeed. I know, I heard that too.
Just some things that maybe you haven't heard before. Stars, we want your routine to be between 2 and 2.5 minutes in length. And like Cindy said, she showed you a picture of the dance floor. You're going to have people on 3 or 4 sides. We think we'll probably move the judges this year over to this section here. We're talking about that. So that means pros, when you choreograph, and stars, when you smile, you're trying to smile towards this side, and this side, and probably nobody in the back except for our wonderful DJs. Anyway, so choreograph your routines that way. The measurements of the dance floor, as we estimated, are on here. So you can plan your routines, you know the size of the floor, you know you want it to face 3 sides. Other than that, it's almost the sky's the limit. If you want to put in costumes, you can. We encourage that. Anything bright and colorful is fabulous. If you want to pick a nice perky routine, or maybe something more elegant, if you want to watch the TV show, it starts on Monday night, the new season, and that'll give you some ideas. Or like Lucia and I always do, we go onto YouTube and just start punching up old Dancing with the Stars routines from the TV show. Very good for inspiration. So, dancers, do you have any questions at all for us?
Who do you send the music to? And what's it built on?
Good question. Number 3, we also need your music in MP3 format. Does that sound right, Jack?
That's it.
Okay. And you could send it to Jack directly, but I guess if you send it to me, then I know who's given their music to Jack, and then I know who to harass in case it hasn't come in.
So before we go on, Tracy and Jack are our DJs. They have been our DJs for the last 2 years, and so we are very excited to have them back. And Jack has put himself out there. He's dancing this year.
So I have asked that you send me the music by October 21st at the latest, if you can. That gives you like more than a month from now. You'll know your music by then. Please send it to us, and then I'll pass it on to Jack, and he'll let us know if he needs something else. Now, Jack has offered in the past. He says he has access to a lot of stuff. And have you said that maybe you can help sometimes?
Yes. Anybody that needs help, either paring down their music to get it within the time limit for the routine or whatever, I can help you get that into the MP3 format and
have it all done for you. Although you're a competitor this year.
So.
That's right.
Because I thought I was the only one that was having that thought. So, hey, Jack, no offense, so but my music's going to your wife.
So if it comes out messed up, it's not my fault.
Correct. Drop the hook.
All right. Fair enough. All's fair in love and dancing.
Absolutely. Let's talk about the awards, the trophies. We have Miraball trophies, and we always give one for the best dancing couple. But the other awards, they go to the people who raise the most money, because we're here for the children, and we thank you for that. So keep that in mind. There are going to be 10 fabulous dancing couples, and only one of them can get the judges' trophy. That means the other ones are vying for the money awards. So please, please help us raise money and just know that ahead of time. The more money you raise, the better your chance of getting a beautiful Miraball trophy. Any other questions? I think that's all I have to say. Lucia, anything else? Okay, we're about ready to announce our couples.
So we will set a date probably the week before the event, Jeff, that we'll send an email out to everybody and say we are going to be practicing at the beach club from 5 to 8 o'clock at night. You guys can come over and practice. Jeff is going to be there. He's going to he'll video us, and then that'll be something that we can rotate and put on to QACTV. In addition, we can also, if you are dancing with your partner and you want to have somebody kind of video it, you can send it to us, and we can put it on Facebook page. We can put it on the website. You know, if you kind of want to show a little bit of a snippet, kind of a taste, kind of say, look at what I'm doing. You know, and we can post it on the site for you as well. Right, Paige? So Paige, this is Paige Todd. She's our webmaster and Twitter master and whatever master. But in addition this year, I did want to bring up, I know we thought it would be kind of fun to do something a little different. I know we're going to have a fun thing at the end with Jennifer and her husband, correct? Something a fun little dance party. But then in the beginning we thought, you know, we talked about this event is about our kids. And if you know, Queen Anne's County and Kent Island High School are extremely competitive. And we thought, what the world, wouldn't this be fun if we did something to bring the kids in? Now, we're not going to solicit the children and put them on the website and try to raise money off of them. If people donate money that night, that's cool. But what we decided to do is we're going to have
exhibition
before the event starts. So before the judges start to judge, we have a Kent Island cross-country runner and a Queen Anne's cross-country runner who are working out with the Callaways on a little performance, kind of something fun. And Paige happens to be the Queen Anne's cross-country runner. And it's just something fun. It was just the idea was, you know, the schools, I mean, it's a big system, and the idea is, you know, it's all about everybody working together. We thought, what the world? And then we'll figure out a way how we're going to, you know, do it in the schools, just to kind of get people more excited and more involved. And so many, we've done it for 2 years, and there's still people saying, no, we never knew anything about this event. So we're trying to figure out different ways, different venues, how we can reach out. And so hopefully this will be fun. We'll see what happens. I know that Paige and Kate are very excited. We're terrified, one of the above. But it'll be all good. And then these guys will go, so judges, these guys will go, and then your judging can begin. After these guys are going to be like the intro. So they're going to cut the ice. Bam! You see Sherry, but they're going to be that. That is, every year.
Stars, you're dancing with a pro. Now, you have no idea how much thought has gone into these partnerships over the past 4 or 5 months. It's unbelievable, and the partnerships have changed a lot on paper or on my computer back and forth. So we ask you to please be patient with your partner and have fun with your partner, listen to your partner. Stars, your pro has danced a lot, and so your pro has a lot of great ideas, and your pro knows what they are doing. So please listen to your pro. And then pros, your stars, this is their one shot. So we want your input, stars. So we just want you to have a really great time. And when we see you the next time, whether it's practicing on the dance floor at the beach club before the show or during, it's like a big family party. It's really fun. We all know what we've been through before, and it's just a lot of great fun. Everybody's got their makeup on and looking all beautiful and tanned and stuff. It's just a great time. So thank you again for agreeing to be a part of this big, big, giant, wonderful production.
Sydney, I got a question real quick. You first.
No, I want one of those.
Oh. So how many people do we anticipate attend this?
Good question. So the beach club can hold about 220 people. If we get more, that would be amazing. And then we start standing people. But we're at about 220 people. Our contract with the beach club is at 220.
Okay.
So that's kind of what our max is.
Is that the biggest room there?
That's the biggest room. And so what we do, we're in the... I can't remember the name. Sunset.
We're in the big room.
It's the big room. So it's a sunset ballroom, and then the bar is in the back of it. And if you've been there, the bar is in the back of it. The first year we had the silent auction. We're not doing a silent auction this year. So the bar will be in the back, the voting will be back there, and any backup food will be back in that area. All right, I've talked a lot, so you guys ready? Woo! Go roll. So what we're going to do is we're going to give you guys some posters to put around and put them anywhere, everywhere, and make sure everybody gets them. And these are our general posters. And these are just our sponsors that are currently at the bottom. Like I said, we'll change them up. But they're just general. But each couple will probably get like 4 or 5. We can get more. And then we have the pictures that you sent us. We have put in... we put your picture and your star and your pro together and said, this is something that's as well for you. We'll see how this works. You know, some of them, I was praying them and they got a little jaw-jawed up, so if they get jaw-jawed and you want more, just let me know. And this is just kind of get us started today.
It is in our household.
Okay, so the so we are still missing a few stars.
We're missing one star and one pro.
And one pro.
Sorry,
so
that one pro just texted me. She said she kind of forgot.
Oh, okay.
But I'll get her information.
And she's done it before.
She has. Okay. She's so sorry.
Okay. That's all good. And then our other, and that's our, that was our pro. So our star isn't there either. Right. And our star actually is owner of this restaurant, so we'll let him off for now.
So he really doesn't have an excuse.
He really doesn't have an excuse. Okay, so, yay! So our first couple is Mr. Dwayne Borman. So we need you guys to come up here, Dwayne. Come on up.
He's overwhelmed by all the material you gave.
So you need to come on up. Peggy's going to take a picture of you. And your pro is Sherry. Sherry's kind of right here.
So you guys, you can see like in front of me, take a picture. We have to pose. You have to pose. You have to pretend. Last year you stood next to me, remember? Last year we were so cute. Yeah, we twirled and everything. First, twirled and everything. It's like I'm not twirling. All right, so the next couple is Whitney Covington. Yay, can you see him? Take a picture. And we know that her pro is not here. Her pro is Mike Swag. Am I saying that right? Swag. Yay! We'll take that. We are going to meet with. All right. Juvenile, front and center. So scary, isn't it? This is Mr. Phil Juvenile, and he is paired with Kimberly.
I understand the band class had some questions for you today.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
It's a little story. My son plays saxophone.
You don't have to
for
talk.
The high school band.
There's always a story.
All the kids in the band were asking her all these questions about this event. And I'm thinking, oh my gosh, if I know Cindy, she's going to pair me up with her.
Yep.
So I'm looking forward to it.
Yay! Our next is Sonia.
I'm glad.
Sonia?
Yeah.
All right. Sonia, you are here with the echo. Yeah. Yeah. All right. Your posters. Here's your posters.
And Diego has quite a few mirror ball trophies already.
He's
a best champion over and over and over.
He's up in the end either.
Yeah, that's it.
All right, our next dancer is Tip. Come front and center. Year, you will be dancing with the lovely Jennifer Goody. All right.
The color coordinated.
Yeah.
You guys both
live
in the same
area.
Okay. Our next couple is the next one is Ivano Scotto, who owns Good Guys and other barns or whatever. Anyway,
Poorhouse.
Hammer.
Yes.
You will be dancing with Ivano Scotto. Can you come on up? But he is not here. Now, Amber won the first year. Amber Wright. She danced with Mr. Shriga. Paige? Come right here. Okay. All right, our next star is Mr. Tony Walsh. Come on up. Now, not here either. It's Erin Newton. Sharon.
Oh, she's so cute.
She's great. So
she's better for you.
She what are her chances?
Erin did it last year. She did a phenomenal job. She actually got a gold ball trophy as well.
Good.
But all right. Our next one is Miss Diana Harvey. And you, my love, will be dancing with
yes.
Mr. Daryl Calvin. Yeah. Here's your posters. Here's your posters. So the next one is, come join us. He got put in this game on Tuesday of this week. Yeah, thank you for coming. Yay! Now, yay! Natalie is your pro.
And Natalie is another import from Tulloch County. She has her own dancing troupe, and she's done quite a lot of dancing and dancing for the dog shows and that kind of thing.
And last but not least, Mr. Jeff Wilson, come on down. And guess who you're with?
No one left.
No one left.
No one
left.
You're stuck with me.
Oh, I'm happy to be stuck with you, dear.
You can handle them. I'll need tips.
I'm just wondering how we're going to do this.
We're not following the rules, all right?
You are not following the rules. And you're
must be Mr. Zimino's and your grand's.
No, those are both of yours. See, because if you look, you want to see what I did?
We're putting them up.
These are good, Diane. What? Are they cute?
In case you don't know, Sherry here is the owner of a dance studio in Centerville and in Easton, and she has generously offered, if you live nearby and are having trouble finding a place to rehearse, her studio is available, and she's just so generous to do that for us. So one of the first conversations you'll want to have is, where are you going to practice? And so Sherry could be partially a solution or whatever, and that's one thing you'll need to discuss. The other thing is feel free to raise money all the way along up until the big event. Sometimes people do guest bartending and they announce that they put their poster out and people come in and all the drinks they buy, some of the proceeds go to their little charity, which is us, okay? So feel free to do that or be even more creative if you like. Some people actually put on a show ahead of time. So if you've never performed in public before, maybe there's a local group you want to find a room, a church or whatever, and you get your friends together, they all come in and watch you dance and clap, you get to practice in your costume, and they can donate then at that time too. So feel free to practice ahead of time in public if you want, put on shows, raise money, anything you want, and we can give you more ideas if you like. But thanks again, everybody.
And the most important thing in this entire thing, besides, you know, raising money, is to have a blast at it. Because the fun thing is, I did it the first year, is you meet a bunch of new people that you never would have, you know, been hanging out with before. And I can tell you, and those of us who have danced it, the day after the event, it's kind of like, wait a minute, I want to go keep doing it, because it's very fun. It's just, you get wrapped up in it, and it's a hoop. So make sure you have fun. If you're not having fun, call me, and I'll make sure you have fun. All right. Next time we're going to see you guys, you're going to be on the dance floor at about like 6:30. And so what we'll do is we'll have like a team meeting at 6:30 the night of the event. And we'll be emailing and sending out things and letting you know when things are on Facebook and when things are going to be on the radio, so you can kind of keep following along with us. But the next time we're all going to meet as a group is going to be on the dance floor, kind of a go team before the event, with everything set up before anybody else gets there. What will happen is we'll get there earlier, set up the dance floor, it'll all be set up. The committee leaves, then you guys show up like at 4 or so.
Right.
And then you'll have like a room to change in. Depending on what's happening at the beach club, you might have two rooms. There might be a room for the guys and there might be a room for the girls. If the beach club is super busy, there ends up being just a room for the girls, and then the guys get to use the bathroom. But then we'll have just like, you know, drinks and some stuff in the dressing rooms just for you to kind of get ready. And historically, the dancers they kind of, you know, we introduce you in the beginning of the event. What we'll do is we'll introduce our judges, and they come out. Sometimes they'll come out in fun little robes. We'll see how that works this year. And then our master of ceremonies introduces everybody, and you all kind of can come out. And sometimes people are dressed in their costumes, sometimes they're not, because they want to kind of surprise everybody. And then everybody kind of goes back, and then the game begins. So this year, then the game will begin, and then we'll have an intermission. And at intermission, people come out and they, you know, so they see everybody dance and they're like, oh man, I want to dance. So then it gives people in the audience a chance to come out and dance. Then we'll do the other five dances. The judges will then go away and they will vote. And then people come out and dance even more, and then we keep trying to raise more money. And then the judges come out and they announce the winners. And then the night ends at 11, but people really come out and kind of just keep dancing and having fun. I think that's kind of the... Kind of the gist of the whole night, right? I mean, it's pretty...
And you'll have plenty of time for the practice. You'll get two or three times if you need to, easily.
Before
all ten couples can get two or three times. It doesn't take long. It's, you know, you're two and a half minutes. So.
As soon as you know your song, make sure you let us know, because we'll lock it in and nobody else can take your song. We won't have any duplicates. So it's really handy if you'll meet in the next 6 or 7 days. You'll email us the name of your song, and then we'll start putting the lineup together so we separate all the jitterbugs, that kind of thing. And if there's a particular place in the lineup you want, if you want to go first and get it out of the way, email me that, or if you want to be last, and we'll try to work everybody into the routine the night, however that works best for everyone. So let us know when you've decided all these things, please.
So there you go. You guys have questions, you know, always. We have, if you, everybody do the signing sheet, ahead. Thank you guys, and enjoy.
Thank you all.
I baked, and I, you know.